Okay, it is 10:20 at night. Just getting started on these videos, so I'm gonna have some fun. This is a crazy sketchbook that I got, and I've added pages to it. It came with these white pages, and I've added my own. So, like, this is just craft paper. I added this to it, so you know, this we'll do some demos with this. Really fun. And then you have this white paper, which this I haven't drawn on yet. Done some, like, you know, crazy fun stuff, you know, having a good time with it. Different styles, you know, to go from like this wispy drapery, you know, to this painting here, which was really fun, you know, really textural, you know, chamois. Yeah, it's out of proportion. It was pretty funny. This was kind of fun, you know, playing with that. Then I put this paper in here, which we've drawn on before. This is kind of grainy. This is fun. And then, this one. This was cool. See. All very different. So we're going to do a very, very long pose. And here's a gouache. You know, it was fun. I forgot I had that. This is going back to like Art Center time here. So, this amazing model, great guy. The models weren't supposed to talk at Art Center, and but Art Center has never had me as a teacher. And when you're teaching figure drawing, the figure drawing comes from the brain. You know, you got to know who you're drawing, you know. So, I got my, you know, I got a sales background so I can get people talking. And what I did was I would always have the models talk, and the models aren't allowed to talk. But again, I made them talk and just asking them questions about their life. And this guy was amazing. He's an actor, and it was really fun. So had that. This was one of the artists, one of the models at Art Center. And, you know, I just got him talking. And then the students can get into who the person is. Because if you're just drawing flesh, I mean, that's kind of morbid. This was the paper from Art Center. And when I was going through my orientation, one of the artists that teaches there, he took me aside and he said, you know, you get some money for supplies. So he said, make sure you go to the student store and buy some supplies. Well, what do I need? You know, I don't really need much. I was using my own supplies. I have supplies, you know. But I thought, all right, I'll get some paper. So I bought this paper, and you know, I was there for one semester, but I scored some good paper. But look at that. What a model. God, he was great. And this was, you know, sitting right in front of me. So this was really fun. So this is a fun book, and I thought we would draw from this. And so here we go. The one thing that I noticed from the internet, and this is going to sound really weird coming from me, is that people talk too much. It's like, you know, everybody's talking, and let's see if this is a pencil I want to use. Maybe not. The one thing that we got to remember is that when we're drawing, we're not talking. So what I'm going to do is introduce to you the most amazing tool that you can use as an artist, and it's this. So one thing that, you know, students tell me that they like about the videos is they draw along, you know, with my drawing. And that's a great compliment, and that's what I love that. So, what we're going to do is we're just going to draw together. Sorry, I've already chosen a pose. I'm just trying to choose the color I want. I think we're going to have to use, this will be contrasting color, this red. So we'll do that. Oops. And then I'll use white chalk. So I've chosen, it's the Rock Hits, Apple Music Classic Rock Hits from 1975. That was when I was in high school. And music never got any better since then. So what I'm going to do is do a really long pose. And then what will happen is Corey will piece it together. But I'm going to do it with my headphones on. So I'll let you know when I'm going to stop. And we'll go from there. Let's see which lighting I want. So it's very, you know, very real, and I'm keeping everything super low tech because everything else out there is really high tech. But one of the things that I'm seeing is, you know, people are just talk, and, you know, there's a, once you start working, you know, talk. So I'm going to talk, I'm going to say a few things. We get started, but one of my favorite quotes was from a guy named Tim Gula. If you're out there, Tim, just calling you out for being amazing. We used to draw together when I was just my early 20s on Sunday at the sketch groups. He's brilliant. He's still out there because I've seen him posting on Instagram. And Tim had a saying, and he would say, "Stop your jawing and start your drawing." And you know, so that's what we're gonna do. The other thing is I'm hearing a lot of people, it's like, you know, it's like the psychology, you know, there's like so much psychology going on right now, you know, on these, on the internet. It's like, I feel like giving up art and all this kind of stuff. Let me give you a little hashtag secret. Nobody forces anybody to be an artist. It's a tough field, and you better love it. And it, you know, it's gotta be your passion. And, so, I mean, I've been doing this, you know, a friend of mine, I was teaching a class today out of Arkansas, and my mentor and friend that I teach, you know, he's, you know, I get to sit in on the class, and, you know, I get to partially teach the class. And he says to the guy, he says, "I'm going to tell you a secret." And the guy goes, "What?" He goes, "Sheldon's old," because I had a birthday, and I made it to 61. The guy goes, "Really?" And I said, "Yeah, but I work with kids, which makes me younger." I'm as excited now as I was when I was 14, and I'm still studying the same stuff. So even though I'm 61, I'm still listening to the same music and studying the same stuff and trying to learn this drawing, and just loving it. Okay, so let's not, you know, to give up, that's silly. You know, this is your passion. And if you are going to give up, then people will probably just say, "Yeah, do it," because, you know, it's a field that's difficult and it's got to have a passion. Okay, so let's do that. So let's love it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put on my headphones. It looks like the first song is, as we bow at the knees when we say this gentleman's name, Bruce Springsteen. See, I just bowed at the knees. So Bruce Springsteen, I bowed again. And, so we're going to start with some Born to Run, and then it moves on to highly religious music, which is the Church of Led Zeppelin, which is Kashmir. Right after that, Aerosmith. Ooh, yeah. Okay, so I'm going to shut up, put my headphones on, we'll draw together. I have a pose I can't show you because the person's naked, but you'll see as the drawing progresses, it'll take as long as it takes, and I'm going to get lost in this drawing, and then you guys get lost in your drawing. If you want to draw along with me, you can. I just can't show you the model. And these headphones my daughter gave me, and they're pretty badass. They sound good. Okay, you ready? So I'm going to shut up, and we're going to draw. This is 9 minutes into it, so I'm going to press stop and start again, just so it's easier for us to edit. All right, it's time to... So if we're in a studio, you come in the morning. How are you? How you doing? You know, what'd you do over the weekend? What'd you do last night? And you chit, chit, chit. And then these headphones go on, and... maybe you talk again at break time, you know, 2.5 hours. It goes by really fast. We're very lucky to have this field that we're in called art. Okay, I'll see you guys in a little while. Okay, so notice how you're just kind of sweating through it, you know? You just keep going. It's really fun. So in the model picture, her head is going down, but the drawing seems to want it to go up. So at a certain point, there's a saying that I love, which is the drawing or the painting is the experience. So you want to, you know, let it take, like for instance, you know, I thought I was going to be listening to certain music, and I guess this is on shuffle. So I'm getting all kinds of other stuff. So, you know, it's not, you're not going to be able to plan everything. You don't plan out your life that way. You don't, you know, life is experience and drawing is experience. You're the same. Okay, so that's what we're doing. So that's where I'm at right now, and see where you keep going. You know, just taking it fun, taking it slow. Okay, that was 11 minutes. Let's put pause and keep going. Okay, I think that might be about it for this one. If you can hear Bruce in the background, so we gotta stop that. I'm gonna get in trouble. All right, so this is it. It's fun. Now the face I completely made up, because in the photo, you know, she's looking down, but it just didn't seem to work. So what you want to do is let the drawing be the journey. And this is going to sound kind of trippy, but life is not a straight line and your career is not a straight line. Art training is head drawing, figure drawing, perspective, landscape composition, value, and color. That's a straight line, but the journey is infinitive. And the more you learn, the more you realize you don't know. So you're never gonna get to the point where you say, okay, I got it. If it gets easy, you're probably doing it wrong. If you feel like you wanna quit and give up, well, yeah, I mean, anything that's worth it, anything that's difficult, you know, you get frustrated. But to give up in art, I mean, nobody ever says to you, you have to be an artist. It's what you're born to do. It's what you love. And that's kind of, so we'll end it where we started, with a really close friend of mine announcing to another guy that I really respect. You know, I don't know him as well, but what I know of, I've worked with him, I really love this guy. And he's really powerful. And he says, you know, Sheldon's old. And I'm just laughing because, I mean, I still act like I'm 12. I think the point is that it takes till you're 61 to really begin to understand this stuff. And, you know, like Vilppu will say, you know, come back in 40 years. It's like, I mean, I'm staring at a Vilppu drawing on my wall. It's the best, my favorite drawing he's ever did for me. I did it in, he signed it, but didn't date. It was probably done when I was 21 years old. He even looked at it and went, that's a good drawing. I have it on my wall. This drawing's like, God, about 40 years old. And I just stare at it every day in awe. So yeah, it takes till you're 61 to finally start to understand, but that doesn't mean your career starts then. Okay. So let's have fun. Let's enjoy it. I really like this headphone stuff. So I think we'll do more of these because I can get lost in the drawing too. Okay, this one's 18 minutes. It's going to be hard to download. I'll see you on the next drawing, you guys.